Yeah.
This leads us to integration by partial fractions. What are partial fractions? Partial fractions is like we are breaking down an expression, which is a fraction, down into different fractions, which we can bring together to give the initial fraction. And there is a technique of handling that. It's a special topic in mathematics, which is not that hard. Let me remind us of some points while we are handling, while we are breaking down a fraction into partial fraction. Denominator degree must be lesser than the denominator power. That is the first one. The second one is that if the denominator is a linear factor, that is the first, as in the simplest factor, it should be linear. To give you any power of x, it should be linear expression, linear factor. The partial fraction must give us a form a over alpha x plus beta. You know, if the if you have one of the denominator as alpha x plus beta, you are going to have a constant over this. This is the only way you can have a power, a degree, that must be lesser than this one. That is, you know, this is x raised to the power 1, so this one will be x raised to the power 0. This is the only way you can have it. And the next one is, if the denominator contains factor alpha x plus beta, and then you bracket it all squared. When you break it down, you must break it down into a over alpha x plus beta, b over alpha x plus beta squared. You can see. It must contain one linear, two linear, second linear, and squared. If the form is alpha x plus beta cube, it leads to, you can see, a over alpha x plus beta plus b over alpha x plus beta squared plus c over alpha x plus beta cube. That's it. If the denominator is of the quadratic form, you can see now. So which means that the numerator will be a power lesser or a degree lesser than the denominator. So we have it to be ax plus b over alpha x squared plus beta x plus gamma. Very easy. And then by the time you do one or two examples, everything you recall how we do everything. Now that we have reminded ourselves of how to handle partial fractions, now these examples will remind us totally how to do it, and they will teach us how to use partial fractions in different in integration. Let's do these examples. We have this like x plus 1 over x squared minus 3x plus 2 dx. So if we break this down, we are going to have it like this. X plus 1 over x minus 1 into x minus 2 dx. That's for sure. Now, for us to continue, we need to break this down into x plus 1 to x minus 1 into x minus 2. It will give us a over x minus 1 plus b over x minus 2. You can see, partial fraction is applicable in several places. This is one of the places. This is one of the places. Now, we know what to do. We multiply 2 by this denominator, and that's going to give us x plus 1 to give us a into x minus 2 plus b into x minus 1. The simplest way is to zeroize each of these brackets in terms. How do I know? For this one now, let's make x to be equal to 2. So this one is going to be 2 plus 1 will be equal to a into 2 minus 2 plus b into 2 minus 1. So you can see, it makes this one 0. It makes the job very easy. So we have 3 will be equal to b. So we have our b already. Now let's zeroize this one too. Let's make x to be equal to 1. So we are going to have 1 plus 1 will be equal to a into 1 minus 2 plus b into 1 minus 1. So you can see, this one becomes 0 automatically. So we have 2 equals to minus a. So a equals minus 2. So which makes our job easier now? We can easily break this down into partial fractions. So we can now write it down as this. It's going to be b, that is 3 over x minus 2 minus 2 over x minus 1. So dx, dx. So it makes our job very easy now. Now, Looking at this, we can easily write this as the 3 into dx over x minus 2 minus 2 into dx over x minus 1. Looking at this, if you differentiate this one, it's going to give you this. If you differentiate this expression, it's also going to give you this. You can see that it has made our job very easy. So we can say 3 ln x minus 2 minus 2 ln x minus 1 plus. So that is all. Now we have another one. X squared over x plus 1 into x minus 1 squared. We have been, they have already factorized that one for us. It makes our job very easy. So we can now see it's going to give us a over, okay, let me leave it like that. So let's quickly break it into partial fractions. We are going to have x squared over x plus 1 into x minus 1 all squared will give us a over x plus 1 plus b over x minus 1 plus c over x minus 1 squared. You know, we have already stated this in the rules. Multiply through by this denominator, we are going to have x squared equals to a into x minus 1 all squared plus b into x plus 1 into x minus 1 plus c into x plus 1. Very straightforward. Now let's quickly see what we can do. Let's introduce x to be equal to 1. X equals 1. So we are going to have this one as 1. So this one is going to give us a into 0 plus b into 0. Because this one becomes 0, it multiplies everything. So and this one plus c into 1 plus 1. Therefore, we have 2c is equal to 1. So c equals to half. Now let's make x to be equal to minus 1. So we have 1 because minus 1 squared is equal to a into minus 1 all squared plus b into 0 plus c into 0. So from here we can also get 1 is equal to 4a. So a is equal to 1 over 4. You can see that our job is becoming easier now. Now, let me, to undo this b part, let me just make x to be equal to 2. So that this place will be 1, and this place will be, so let's do it. So we are going to have 2 squared is equal to 1 over 4. What is this? 2 minus 1, all squared, plus b, into 2 plus 1, into 2 minus 1, plus c into 2 plus 1. And mind you, we have already gotten the values for c and a. So it makes our job very easy. So we are going to have 4 equals to 1. Okay, I've given you it here. 1 over 4 plus b into 3 plus half. That c is half plus 3 over 2. So I'm going to have it like this. 3b is equal to 4 minus 1 over 4 minus 1 and half, which is 3 minus 3 over 4. That is equal to 2 1 quarter, which gives me 9 over 4. So you can see, so b is equal to 9 over 4 times 3, which is 3 over 4. So you can see the job is very sweet and easy now. I can now express this as a partial fraction. So I can now write this as, what's my a? 1 over 4 into x plus 1 plus, what's my b? 3 over 4 into x, 1 over x minus 1 plus half 1 over 2 into x minus 1 squared dx. So you can see With this, we can bring out some standard, we can now use some standard results. Now you can see that we can write it out like this. Now, we can now take it in turns. So this one is going to give us, if you look at this, this is the differential of this one. So I can easily say 1 over 4 ln x plus ln x plus 1 plus 3 over 4 ln x minus 1. Now this one is different. So I have to handle that one separately in a different manner. So if you look at this, the x up is the differential of this. So I'm going to do it like this. Du over u squared. So you can see, du over u squared. I am just writing it out for explanation. I would have done it straight. So I see that if you are going to integrate something like this, it's u minus 2 plus 1 over u over minus 2 plus 1. You can see. So at the end of the day, I am having something like this, u raised to the power minus 1 over minus 1. See. So what does that give me? It will give me half into x minus 1 raised to the power minus 1 over minus 1 plus c. So my final result is going to be something like this. 1 over 4 ln x plus 1 plus 3 over 4 ln x minus 1 minus 1 over x 2 into x minus 1 plus c. So you can see, it makes the job very easy and straightforward. So now we have another expression. X squared over x minus 2 into x squared plus 1 dx. Now, before we continue, let's first of all break it down into partial fractions. So we have it to be x squared over x minus 2 into x squared plus 1. And that's going to give us a over x minus 2 plus b x plus c over x squared plus 1. Please note, this one must be a power lesser than this. So at the end of the day, your b might be 0 or anything, but just first of all express it like this. Let's multiply 2 by this denominator. We are going to have it to be x squared, to be a into x squared plus 1 plus bx plus c brackets into x minus 2. Let x be equal to 2. If x equals to 2, so this place will be, so that this place will be 0, this place is going to give us 4 equals to a into 5. So our a will give us 4 over 5. Now let's make x to be 0. So that if we eliminate this part. So we are going to have 0 is equal to 4 over 5. You can see this part alone. And this one will be 0 plus c into minus 2. You can see 0, 0, 0. What do we have now? We have 4 over 5 is equal to 2c. So c is equal to 2 over 5. 2 over 5. So there are several ways I can use to get my b now by equating the powers of x and whatever after expansion. But I don't want to go through that route. Let me just make x to be 1. It is the simplest value I can use here. I can use half, I can use 1. So let me use 1. So this place is going to be 1. I know the value of a already, and that is 4 over 5. 1 plus 1, 2, plus b, plus what is my c, 2 over 5, 1 minus 2, minus 1, 2, I can work now. So it's going to give me 1 minus 8 over 5 will be equal to b, minus 2 over 5. So I can now say that now to find b, the easiest thing I can do is to make x equal to 1, or I expand and then equate the powers. I can look anything. Since I have known the value of a and c, it's only b I'm looking for. I can use any figure. But the easiest one I can use now is 1. If I use anything like 0, this place will eliminate. So now let's do it. So if I use 1, this is going to be 1 will be equal to A into 1 squared plus 1 plus B into 1 plus C into 1 minus 2. Now, let me substitute quickly. I'm going to have 1 equals 4 over 5 times 2 plus, this is minus 1, and this is going to be minus B minus, what is C? 2 over 5. This will give me 6 over 5 minus B. Therefore, I can now say 1 minus 6 over 5 is equal to minus B. So what does that give me? Minus 1 over 5 is equal to minus B. So B is equal to 1 over 5. So I can write this out here as 4 over 5 into 1 over x minus 2. Plus, you can see that 5 is common here. I can put 1 over 5 here into x plus 2 over x squared plus 1. So you can see, it makes my job very easy to undo now. Now, let's continue. This one can be easily undo now. So I can just easily say, this one is 4 over 5 dx over x minus 2 plus 1 over 5. If I differentiate this one, it's going to give me 2x plus 2x. It's going to give me 2x. So you can see this one is now going to give me 2x plus 2 over x squared plus 1 over 2 over x squared plus 1. You can see I break it into two parts so that I'll be able to use logarithm in this place. So let me now make it like this. 2x dx, 2dx. So you can see what it now turns out to be. And this one now gives me 4 over 5 dx over x minus 2 plus, looking at this, 1 over 10 2x dx over x squared plus 1. Please note, this one, I use this one to multiply this outside so that this one will be like this. Now, this one is existing like this. I can also write it like this. Plus 2 over 5 dx over x squared plus 1. You know what I've been trying to do? To extract standard integrals. That's what we are trying to do. So this one is now going to give us 4 over 5 ln x minus 2 plus 1 over 10 ln x squared plus 1 plus 2 over 5 arctan x. Remember, arctan x plus c. You can see. So partial fraction makes this expression that we don't have standard integral for, breaks it down to something we can do, even though it is combination and combination from several patterns. Now, looking at this, we have 4x squared plus 1 over x into 2x minus 1 all squared. So the easiest thing to do is to break it first into its partial fractions. So let's do it. 4x squared plus 1 over x into 2x minus 1 all squared. That's going to give us a over x plus b over 2x minus 1 plus c over 2x minus 1 all squared. Now let's multiply 2 by the denominator. We are going to have 4x squared plus 1 is going to give us a into 2x minus 1 all squared plus b into x into 2x minus 1 plus c into x. Now, let's look at something. The easiest thing to do is to make x to be equal to 0. So if you make x to be 0, this space will be 1. This space will be a into, what is minus 1 squared? 1. This space will be 0. This space will be 0. So a equals 1. That one goes like that. Now, let's look at another thing we can do. Let's make x to be half. If we make x to be half, let's see. So this will be 4 into half squared plus 1. If x is half, this space will be 0. If x is half, this space will also be 0. So we are going to have c times half. Working this out, this space will be 1 plus 1, 2, is equal to c over 2. So c is equal to 2 times 2, which is 4. So c equals to 4. So now, with this, I can now work out b. Let me see, what is the simplest word I can use for b? Let's say I use 1. Okay, let's use 1. So we can say 4 plus 1 is equal to, what is this one going to be? A into 1 plus b into 1, 1 plus c. And we know the value of a, we know the value of c. So let's quickly do it. So it's going to be 5 equals what is a? 1 plus b plus 4. So which is 5 plus b? Therefore, b equals 0. So you can see. So I can easily write this out as 1 over x plus, this one is 0, so I don't need to write it. So plus 4 over 2x minus 1 all squared dx. So you can see it's very simple now. So the simple way is to look at it. Is this one equal to the differential of this? Let's see. If I differentiate this one, 2x minus 1, what does it give me? 2. So I can now write it out as, let's see. If this one is u, 2x minus 1 is equal to u. So what is the, so if I'm going to have n, 2 is equal to du. Yes. So du will be equal to 2 dx. Now I want to work this out. So I can easily write this one out as dx over x plus 2 into 2 dx over 2x minus 1 all squared. You see? So it's going to give me in x plus 2 into 2x minus 1 raised to the power minus 2 plus 1 over minus 2 plus 1 plus c. You can see? So it makes the job very easy. So I have been x minus 2 into 2x minus 1 raised to the power minus 1 plus c. And I can write that as ln x minus 2 over 2x minus 1 plus c. So thanks for being part of this program. If you have followed up to this extent, it means that you are a fan. Kindly subscribe, follow where necessary, comment, share, let others also know about it. And if you have any comments, please make it. You can also contact if you have any question to solve through the channels in the description. Thank you.